Hello everyone, welcome to science class. I hope you all are doing well. So we have finished chapter 13, force, work and energy. Today we are going to summarize the chapter. So all living beings, whether it is plants, humans, animals, they need energy to do their day-to-day activities. So what is an ultimate source of energy? How do we get this energy from? Do we need some energy to move any object? Yes. So for all these queries, we are going to have an answer in this chapter. So force, work and energy, they are very important aspect of our life. Force, we use force in most of our daily activities like picking or throwing objects, mopping a floor, opening or shutting a door, etc. So a push or pull is called force. It can cause things to start, it can cause things to stop, then it can change shape, it can change direction also. Now work means any physical or mental activity. For example, reading a book is a mental activity, whereas lifting a book is a physical activity. So work is said to be done when a force applied on an object moves it by some distance. Energy is defined as the ability of a body to do work. All living beings need energy for their activities. Now we have different kinds of force. First one is muscular force. This force we use to do our physical activities, for example, playing, lifting objects. So this force is exerted by our muscles. That is why it is called as muscular force. Then we have mechanical force. So machines use mechanical force to work. Then we have elastic force. So when we use certain machines like bow and arrow, we use this force.
Gravitational force.
You know that Earth pulls everything towards it. This force is called gravitational force. So whenever we throw something in the sky, it eventually falls down. We have frictional force. Now moving things slow down because of some pressure, because of some force, is called as frictional force. For example, bicycle and pedaling. So we can move bicycle by pedaling. Then magnetic force. Magnet attracts certain metals towards it, for example iron, that is called magnetic force. Now work, some certain machines, they make our work easier. In them we have certain machines which make our work easier, like lever, it helps to lift heavy objects. Then pulley, machines like cranes and sailboats use pulley to lift heavy objects. Then wedge, it is used to split things apart, for example knives and axes, forks. Then screw, it is used to hold up things. Then we have energy. How can we get energy and various forms of energy? For example, sun. So sun gives us energy, which we call it as solar energy. So this energy is used in all purposes. One of them is generate electricity. So to produce electricity, we use solar energy. Then we have wind. So windmill use high pressure or high flow of wind to generate electricity. Then water, dams use the force of fast flowing water to generate electricity. And the last one is fuels. So coal, petrol, oil, wood are used as fuel. So this is all about the chapter force, work and energy. I hope you have understood this chapter well. I will see you all in the next class. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.